Well, nothing is wrong with them. They're normal. Social relationships become more about quality than quantity. And lastly, there's shrinkage of your ability to get a job. You may have spent the last 20 or 30 years taking care of your family, and the workplace is just not what it used to be. Many women try to return to a previous career only to find that they are undesirable as employees. Now, this is not only unacceptable, it's really very sad because menopausal women make some of the best employees ever. The workplace is just not accommodating to menopausal women, but it's a great time for starting your own business or turning a hobby into a business. And hopefully this menopause revolution I'm trying to create will change things for women as they embark on the longest phase of their lives. So there you have it, the things that shrink at menopause. And what you'll see in this WHAM, What Happens at Menopause series, is that there may be some overlap from one category to another. That's intentional. I want you to see themes. So last week, you learned that your vagina dries up at menopause, and this week, you learned that it shrinks. You see, when you realize that a single occurrence affects multiple parts of your body or multiple parts of your life, it really helps you to connect the dots. So that's why I teach like this, and I try to come at things from very different angles. And so when you start seeing these themes and you start seeing how many different things in your life they affect, you start having these aha moments of, oh, that makes so much sense. And my hope is that you realize that you're normal and that you don't guilt yourself into thinking that you should be something other than you are not. That gets you nowhere. You know, by the time you get to be menopausal, you really, really have a pretty good grasp on life and on the world and how things work. And while you might have tried to navigate through your life by, you know, making everything the way everyone else wants it to be, you kind of come to terms with the fact that you can't change other people. You can't make someone else happy. You can't change Mother Nature. You are not necessarily in control of everything that happens. And so coming to terms with that and getting comfortable with it, see, I think that's a great thing. I think of that as liberating. I think of it as maturity. And I think of it as a very good thing. And if only it could happen early in our lives. You see, menopause can be the greatest thing. And even though certain things are going to shrink, some of those shrinkages free you up. The social one is the one that women are so, I will say, shocked by, but also relieved by. I get comment after comment after comment from women talking about how they just didn't understand why they stopped caring about doing things with other people, doing things for other people, doing things because of other people, doing things instead of other people, being upset if they didn't take care of everything for other people. And they stop caring about all that. And then they wonder why they stop caring. And many times they feel guilty. They feel guilty about things like disinterest in wanting to put up their holiday decorations, disinterest in wanting to make that big meal for the whole family. Well, by golly, why should they have had to do that all those years anyway? Why did they get targeted as the person responsible for all that? It's fine for someone else to do some of those things. It's fine to share that effort, that share that work. So it's the kind of thing where more women need to start understanding that some of these shrinkages at menopause actually give them some freedom and hopefully some joy. Now, I know that there are some that aren't so great. The shrinkage of the vagina creates the biggest problem for women. And the reason it creates the biggest problem is, first of all, they don't know what's happening. Women have no idea that their vagina is shrinking. I think it's one of the biggest, most important things to know about menopause. Because, you know, you can't see your vagina. There's no way for you to know that it's shrinking by looking at it or examining it. You can't take note of that. You have to just know that that's what's happening. based on the fact that you are having certain symptoms. So if you have any itching, any burning, any dryness, any pain during intercourse, any tearing during intercourse, anything like that, they're all the same thing. Your vagina is shrinking. And if you don't do something to stop it, it will continue shrinking. And here's the biggest thing to understand. As much as you may wish and hope that many different things can prevent shrinkage of your vagina, they can't. There is one magic thing for your vagina, and it is estrogen. Your vagina is the most selfish place on your body when it comes to estrogen. It wants more estrogen than any other part of your body, and if it doesn't get what it wants, it shrinks, period. So all the lubricants in the world will not prevent vaginal shrinkage. In fact, lubricants aren't even for your vagina, they're for your sex life. They make it possible to have intercourse. So they're really kind of more for your partner than they are for you. No vaginal moisturizer will prevent shrinkage of your vagina. Nothing will prevent shrinkage of your vagina except estrogen. That's all your vagina cares about. So just knowing that is critical. And so coming at these topics, these different things that happen at menopause as themes kind of helps you start using the information in a way that allows you to see the principle and then apply it to different things that are happening when you're going through menopause. I love, love, love giving you this education. And my goal is to meet your needs no matter how you learn, no matter what your timeline, and no matter what your budget. So that's why I have these podcasts, because they're great for people who learn in an auditory way and who can get the podcast without having to pay money to get them. It's also wonderful to go to my YouTube channel, which is also free. And those people who are visual and need props and models to understand things, you get all of that on the videos, and I go into great detail and really, really, really show you in so many different ways how things really work. If you're a person who likes to read, my book is fantastic for giving you all the information you need. If you would want the whole education in a short period of time, all at once, you have two choices. Well, three choices, really. Your first choice is you can watch the entire two-day seminar as webinars. It's 15 webinars. You need to watch them consecutively in order 1 through 15. Don't jump around. That'll mess you up. Or you can get the whole education on DVD, all from my website, menopausetaylor.me. Both require you to watch them in order to really get it, because, you know, it's like any learning endeavor. You got to learn the alphabet before you learn to read. Jumping around never gets you anywhere. And the other option is to schedule a one-on-one consultation with me. And what's great about consultations is that I give you a whole background review. I give you basically the whole education, but I also tailor everything to you. That's the only product with my education where you get me all to yourself, and I just tailor everything to you so that you have exactly what you need for your particular situation. So regardless of which of these appeals most to you, just know that they all exist. Know that I'm happy, happy, happy to do this for you. I love helping you, and I love knowing that you're taking advantage of it and getting the education that all women deserve. And I hope that these themes help you to see the common things that happen in various aspects of your body and your life, because menopause affects both your body and your life, and it affects them all for the rest of your life. So this education, this part of your life, it is by far the most important, and I'm putting you in control. So I am Menopause Taylor. I'm signing off for now. Come back and see me next week when I'll cover what grows at menopause. It'll be the next in the WHAM series. Go to my website, menopausetaylor.me, for all the goodies. Bye.